Tales of Captain Crow, Chapter 23, The Legend of Gwen Batterby. There's not a soul on the sea that doesn't shudder when a blood moon rises in the night sky. It's a sign, they say. A sign that a deal's been made with none other than Gwen Batterby, the notorious weapons dealer and practitioner of the dark arts. They say she's lived for 1,000 years, promising to fulfill any seafarer's desire for revenge. But it comes at a terrible price, for those who enter a pact with Gwen Batterby are forever lost. To find her, one must sail to Mukesh Island, a barren rock on the edge of the known world and refuge for pirates and outlaws. Those who climb the broken stairs that wind their way to Batterby's lair are driven by delusion, believing it will be them among all others who will escape the spider's web. Those fool enough to enter her terrible workshop will find themselves transported to the realm of nightmares. The burning smell of sulfur, the heat of the furnace, and the grinding of the mill conspire to overwhelm the senses. And to look upon her is to gaze into the abyss. To approach her is to walk away from your own humanity. To behold her mortal form, bent by centuries of work, is to write one's final chapter. To see her scornful smile and her malevolent gaze is to look into the face of death itself. Yet she is but a mirror, a reflection of one's own twisted desires. For it is the beholder, not Gwen Batterby, who is the architect of their destruction. Ooh, I love a good scary story. I'd like to meet that Gwen Batterby one day, see if she's as bad as they say. Might just need a hug or something. Maybe she's hungry. I know when I'm hungry, I'm awful.